Welcome back to Razorback Reels. I'm Ben Sawyers.
And I'm Elena Thompson. We're back to bring you the best of the entertainment world and some holiday cheer this week. Up first, let's take a look at all the festive things trending on the web.
Now, first off, we've got this Mariah Carey menu from McDonald's that's come out. We've got a full page here, kind of listing each of the days you go, you'll buy something from McDonald's through the app, and they'll essentially just give you what they, what's for that designated day for free. Now, Elena, I know that I'm looking at this list, and I see some hits, and I see some major misses. So I'm gonna, like, which one of these just, like, sticks out to you as, like, this is not, like, this isn't worth it?
I think that the Christmas Eve one is the one that's not worth it. It's just two cookies on Christmas Eve, and that seems kind of boring.
Two cookies on Christmas Eve, yeah. That's my problem with this list. It's like, you start out strong with a Big Mac. A Big Mac's, like, a prize. Oh, see, we're getting, it is for Santa. Like, we got our lead producer here telling us it's for Santa. I guess that's true. That makes a bit more sense. But otherwise, if we're looking at this like a value proposition, like, we're running through, like, the 13th, that's a Big Mac. That's, like, the best value on this whole entire menu. But then you got, like, cookies at the last, it doesn't make sense. Apple pie on the 20th, like, apple pies are, like, a dollar from McDonald's. So I don't see as much value in this. But also, my problem lies in December 15th, in the cinnamon roll. Now, I am not a fan of the McDonald's cinnamon roll because there is something they had far better in the past that they discontinued, and that is the McDonald's Cinnamelt. And the McDonald's Cinnamelt is one of the best menu items McDonald's has ever had. I used to get that for breakfast as a child.
I did, and, too.
I mean, just phenomenal. So, McDonald's, I think you just got to step up your game here a bit. I think some of these are just, like, real misses. Some of them are hits. I've never really gotten pancakes from McDonald's. Have you? I guess they're called hotcakes there. Are they good?
They're kind of good, though. Like, I do like them. I get them sometimes.
I mean, that may be a move, but I'm more of a McGriddle guy myself, you know?
I mean, yeah, but they're, like, kind of similar.
Yeah, I mean,
like,
I guess.
Yeah, like...
But it doesn't have sausage with it, you know? But, yeah. Nonetheless, let's talk about Hallmark movies, Elena. Do you get involved in Hallmark movies at all? Do you get invested?
Not at all. Like, not even a little bit. I cannot tell you a single Hallmark movie that I've seen. I know sometimes that they play in the background at my house, and I know that they have the exact same plot all over and over again. But I don't know. What are your thoughts on them? Do you ever watch them?
I have watched, like, two or three maybe in my lifetime, just because, like, my dad brings us together. And he's like, let's watch this holiday movie together. And there was one, 2 years ago, maybe a year ago now, called Christmas at Graceland. And my dad's like, it's about Memphis. And one, if you're from Memphis, like, Graceland is the last place you ever want to go. It's the worst. I don't recommend Graceland. This is an anti-Graceland podcast here. But nonetheless, it was not a good movie. It was really bad. It was, like, all throughout, I just wanted to leave. I just wanted to turn it off. And so I'm not a fan of Hallmark movies. I don't think that's a real hot take anywhere. Some people are in love with Hallmark movies, but for real, I think you got to be like 60 years old plus if you are a fan, or at least just like the lowest common denominator. I don't know.
Yeah, I agree. I think you just got to be a little bit, I don't know, lonely to like Hallmark movies so much.
Oh, that's really sad, Elena. That was mean.
I mean, come on, though. I don't know. Anyway.
Well, either way, when we come back from the break, Razorback Reels reporters Phoebe and Yael will be in studio.
Be sure to stick around. Coming off of Cyber Monday, I know that many people completed their Christmas shopping or was reminded that we needed to get those.
We have two Razorback reporters here in studio to talk about all the things that are trending when it comes to presents. Take it away, guys.
Hi, welcome back to Razorback Reels. I'm Phoebe Harris.
And I'm Yael Evan. Thanks for joining us.
With the holiday season right around the corner, Yael and I are here to share with you the gifts that are sure to make you the best gift giver of the season.
Every year there's that one person that claims they want nothing, but here are some gifts that everyone is sure to love. First, we have AirPods. Who doesn't need a pair? Whether you're traveling, working, walking on campus, or exercising, these are the perfect gift for everyone.
One of the best gifts you can give, in my opinion, is an experience, like a concert, sports game, or a play. And even better, this is something you can do together.
And who doesn't need a great outfit for the upcoming holiday festivities? Get the special woman in your life a new set of earrings or a necklace to add the perfect touch to their outfits.
And you can't forget about the special men in your life either. Get your guy his favorite cologne or a new pair of boots or tennis shoes.
I don't know about you, Phoebe, but the guys in my life never turn down a good pair of sweatpants, a new wallet, or either, especially if I stick a 20 in it, too.
Well, Yael, what do you think we should get the family members that are always on the go?
I think one of the best gifts to give and receive is luggage. We will all need it at some point in our lifetime, whether we are flying or on the road.
I struggle with what to get grandparents sometimes, but a framed photo of the family always is a hit at family Christmas.
That, Phoebe. What did you ask for Christmas?
Well, my list is full of all the new fashion trends and even a few things we've mentioned tonight.
It seems like that's all the time we have.
Let us know in the comments what you're planning on giving this season. We wish you a happy holidays.
Thanks for joining us. We'll see y'all next year.
Thanks, ladies. Ben, have you completed your Christmas shopping?
I have not started my Christmas shopping. I've been really bad this year. I mean, I've done a lot of shopping for myself in recent days. I mean, Black Friday, Cyber Monday, I definitely got in on some of those deals, you know, because I do not shop for myself enough. But, I mean, I've got no clue what I'm going to get people for Christmas yet. So I'm going to have to go out there and get on it. What about you, Elena?
I got the smallest amount of Christmas shopping done, and that's about it. And so, I don't know. I definitely did not really take advantage of the Black Friday and Cyber Monday deals as much as I should have. But anyway, coming up, we'll continue talking about all things Christmas.
Stick around after the break to find out the movies that will make you feel holly and jolly. Stick around.
When it comes to Christmas, I can't help but get excited to watch all of the Christmas movies.
I mean, there are so many classics that you need to watch during the season, and we have Razorback Reels reporter Lauren to give us the scoop on all the ones we need to watch.
It's that time of year, the year to cozy up on your couch with a warm drink in your hand, flip on your favorite Christmas movie. We all know the classics, It's a Wonderful Life, The Grinch, A Christmas Story, Elf, the list could go on forever. As someone who could watch the Polar Express any time of the year, simply because it takes me back to that happy feeling of what it's like to be a little kid on Christmas, I'm always on the lookout for new Christmas movies. I'm Lauren West, and I'm here to give my take on the new Christmas movies released this holiday season. I often tell myself Home Alone is not a Christmas movie, simply a movie that takes place during Christmas. Kevin is always up to some kind of mischief that ultimately lands him stranded, but in the end, he learns that nothing is more important than his family. And it just so happens to take place in December. I am in no way hating on the plot. In fact, I watched both Home Alone 1 and 2 back in August. I'm just proposing the question, do we really need another one? On November 12th, Disney Plus released the sixth rendition of the classic film, but with a modern twist. The film follows the same plotline as the other five movies. However, small details such as modern toys, electronics, and phrases are integrated. I understand movie remakes will never quite feel like those classics, but I can't help but cringe watching the young children play Fortnite before heading to bed instead of singing in a school Christmas pageant. It's refreshing to see a diverse family on screen, and they even travel to Japan opposed to somewhere in the United States. Although a few of those modern day twists did not please me, I applaud the director for reaching a younger generation with such a classic story. Netflix has released the third version of The Princess Switch, starring Vanessa Hudgens. The Netflix original was released earlier this month and has earned a score of 71% on Rotten Tomatoes. Netflix has been quick to receive hate on Netflix original films, yet found success with the Christmas flick. I was hesitant at first when watching the film, as I hoped it wouldn't follow suit to those cringy Netflix original rom-com movies like Kissing Booth. Sure, it was corny, but what Christmas movie isn't? The whole series has a perfect balance of magic, romance, a touch of drama, and love, something every Christmas movie should always have. Vanessa Hudgens duels as the small-town baker from Chicago and Duchess of Belgravia. Although the first film is primarily about the switch between the identical yet completely different characters, the second and third film incorporate an even grander switch as Vanessa Hudgens plays a third character, a cousin to the Duchess of Belgravia. It was hard to imagine where the plot would lead in the third film, but an exciting heist added a dramatic effect. What I like about this movie is it's different. You could call it Parent Trap Gone Christmas with a sprinkle of duchesses and queens. If Christmas rom-coms aren't for you, Netflix has released something I find out of the box for an original. A Boy Called Christmas follows a young boy named Nicholas on his journey to bring back hope to his village. The beginning of the film follows his trek through the dangerous winter as he searches for a community of elves. I enjoyed that this film was truly made to feel like magic, as Nicholas could only escape the problems he ran into by believing in the Christmas spirit. There aren't too many Christmas movies that have a mythical quest-like plot to it. Not to mention Nicholas's adorable sidekicks, a talking mouse, and Blitzen the reindeer bring in the humor and sweetness to the movie. The only downside to this movie is it most likely isn't for all ages. Something I love about Christmas movies is it brings everyone together, but this Netflix original has some intense scenes that could lead some children dreaming of bear attacks to pose to candy canes. If you're looking for a Christmas quest full of adventure, excitement, love, A Young Boy Called Christmas is perfect for you. That's all the Christmas cheer I have for you today. This has been Lauren West for Razorback Reels. Back to you, Ben and Elena.
Thanks, Lauren. So, Elena, do you have any really like great Christmas movies that you just love to get through this season?
There's really only one that I always make a point to watch, and that's Love Actually. I just think Love Actually is such a great Christmas film. I also always watch A Christmas Story. Ben, you and I were talking about this earlier. It is just constantly playing in the background on Christmas for my family. Trying to think of some other ones. I normally try and watch Elf like once a year, but sometimes it doesn't always happen. What about you?
I mean, Charlie Brown Christmas. Elena, I know you and I were talking about the music from Charlie Brown Christmas. Do you watch that usually?
Yes, I love Charlie Brown Christmas. I don't know how I forgot it, actually. I love Charlie Brown movies, every single one of them. I love them. And I listen to that music all the time.
Yeah, I mean, I like a lot of the old, like, stop-motion ones, you know, like Rudolph. Sometimes it's weird to go back and watch them because they're just, like, some weird things you just did not pick up on as a kid. Just weird. But nonetheless, I love Elf. Like, I think it's a great Christmas movie all around. I just grew up watching it. So, you know, it's one of those that I love. But also, I'm a huge fan of, like, Christmas specials on TV shows. Like, SpongeBob, you can catch me watching that on around Christmas time. And then same with, like, The Simpsons. Like, the episode where they get Santa's Little Helper is, like, a great episode. So I will watch that. Like, and Disney Plus has done a great job of, like, curating the Simpsons content into, like, seasonal kind of little bits there. But nonetheless, let's just move on. We're going to be right back after this break to talk some real talk and get back to the next segment. Stick around.
Now, I know we talked about when we should start celebrating Christmas on an earlier episode.
And now we have some of our Razorback Reels reporters to discuss some hot takes surrounding the Christmas holiday, myself included. Take it away, Riley.
All right. Hey, guys. Welcome back to our final episode of Real Talk. Today, we are going to be talking about hot takes when it comes to Christmas. So, Ben, I want to hear, do you have any hot takes surrounding the holiday?
You know, I don't have much regarding necessarily the holiday itself. I love Christmas. I'm a big Christmas head here. Just the season of giving, it's right up my alley. But I will say, I think people are doing Christmas music all wrong. I think there are some, like, banger Christmas songs, and I am a big music guy. You may not know this, I am a big music guy, but look, I'll give you, like, the number one Christmas song to ever exist is Stevie Wonder's Someday at Christmas. It is not like a traditional banger.
I haven't heard that in so long.
It is a phenomenal song. It tugs at the heartstrings. It's Stevie Wonder, one of the greatest musicians to ever live. And I just absolutely love it. So that's probably my hottest take, is that is the best Christmas song. But also, I mean, you have some classics like, you know, like all the Bing Crosby stuff is kind of great. Just harkening back to a time in music where rock and roll and stuff like that was just starting to kind of get its footing to, like, Elvis Presley and all that. They've got some great Christmas music, but All I Want for Christmas Is You, to me, at this point, the way that it's taken over the holiday, like, right after Halloween, to me, by the time it gets to Christmas, and I've mentioned this before on Reels, it's like, I don't want to hear that song. I really don't. And I will go as far as to say, I mean, in a season of love and giving, I hate that song. I get to a point where I absolutely hate it and cannot stand to hear it. And maybe that makes me a Grinch here or a Scrooge. But, I mean, I think that's my take on it.
I don't think so. I would honestly say I don't mind the song. I don't hate it, per se. But I do think that it is overplayed so much. And I think even now, it's, like, kind of it takes over Christmas, I think, too much. It has too much of a stronghold on the holiday. Then now, even like we've talked about before, McDonald's has this whole thing that's now Mariah Carey, All I Want for Christmas, like menu that they have. I'm like, y'all, you're trying way too hard with this song. You've blown it out of proportion. So I do agree that it is kind of taken a stronghold that it should not have on the holiday. But I would say my hot take for Christmas is, it's kind of odd, but it has to do with Christmas lights. If you are going to hang Christmas lights up on your house, I really dislike the multicolored ones or green. Like, I really just don't like those up on a house. Like, I really am more of like, if you're going to do the multicolored ones, I mean, it's fine. I would rather them be on a tree than on your house. I just like looking at the white lights a little bit better up on the tree, like the house, and then like your tree can be multicolored and things like that. But I don't know what it is on the house. I can't get over it. Or green. I hate the look of green on a house, just like solid green or solid red. Like, I would either like it to be green, red, not a solid color. So I know that's a hot take, but I've just never been a big fan.
You know, okay, I partially agree with you, partially don't. The green, I mean, I don't know anybody who's hanging up solid green lights. If you've seen that happen, I'm sorry.
Bad.
But I mean, I really mess with like the classic just white lights. Yeah, I think that's great for Christmas time. But if you got like alternating white and red, I think that's probably the best, because that's versatile. That's versatile on
very
Christmas.
True.
But also, I think on your point about the classic white lights now, is those are like a year-round thing now. I mean, it's like every restaurant ever that's trying to be like different.
So
it's just like, we're going to hang up Christmas lights year-round. They're going to be the white ones because it's not like seasonal or anything. But I agree with you on the colored. Also, on the like colored lights train here, you know when they came out with like the LED ones? Like, do you remember
yes.
that growing up? It's like we had like the ones that got hot and everything. And
yeah.
then they came out with the LED ones that are safer. But those ones, I don't know, like the blue specifically, it just hurts my eyes and I cannot deal with that at all.
Well,
it's
I'm
too
like,
much.
My eyes can't decide if it's like a blue that's like almost white because it's so bright. Have you ever been driving down the road when someone has like those blue headlights that are like that? That's exactly what it reminds me of.
Believe me, I drive in a low Civic here. So whenever there's a lifted truck with one of those, it's like right in my rear view. It's the worst. I don't like it. It's like you're driving with brights on all the time. It's ridiculous. So
yes,
that's another
That's exactly
take.
What I correlate it with.
Yeah. No, I get that. But like, especially that like really deep blue one that they have. It's like, it's just distracting. I don't know what about it is. It's like my eyes just like go to it. And it's like, that's a hazard for people driving by.
Yes, but no, I would say too, I don't know why on the square they have like, obviously downtown Fayetteville is beautiful, and then they also have in Bentonville the square that they decorate with lights. I don't know why people rave about the Bentonville square than they do more Fayetteville, because I just don't love the look of the green on the grass. For me, I'm just like, I just don't know that I love that. Maybe it's the green lights that are really just throwing me off here, but I'm just not the biggest fan of that. I think it's really cool how they try to mimic the grass, but I prefer the Fayetteville square over the Bentonville square.
I feel the only correct way to utilize green lights in a Christmas decoration display, and this is coming from years of experience having set up the lights at my house with my dad and brother. Painful process, terrible cold process in November. But nonetheless, the only correct way to utilize that is to like get a pole and make them into a Christmas tree. I feel like that's the only place where I've seen that actually work with green lights.
Yes. See, I can appreciate that, but even the grass, I'm like, just let the grass be. You're not even gonna,
yeah.
You're not supposed to be looking at the grass.
No, I mean, the lights are up or in like the bushes. It's not down. You know, when he's like, oh, I like the floor on this one. Like, no, that's not the display we're going for.
Exactly. And so easy to step on too. So,
exactly.
Well, I think that's all the time that we have for this segment of Real Talk. We hope you guys have a fantastic holiday. Merry Christmas. We are going to now send it back to the studio, and we will see you next semester.
Thanks, guys. The both of you have some hot topics for sure. So.
Yeah, I mean.
Anything to add?
You know, Elena, I want to hear some of your takes on Christmas music specifically. Now, what do you think? Like, what's your favorite Christmas song ever?
I really don't have one. I'm not even going to lie to you guys. I just like Charlie Brown Christmas music, and that's about it. The rest of it, I could not care that much about. Wow. If I'm just being truthful.
That's a pretty hot take, Elena. I mean,
I know.
I think my take pretty much is just, like, people need to diversify their music, their Christmas music playlist. I don't want to hear All I Want for Christmas Is Year every year. I want to hear some, you know, Tom Petty or some, like, the Crocodiles have a great Christmas song that came out. Just some more underground stuff. But be sure to stay tuned to find out what our favorite holiday traditions are.
We'll be right back after the break.
To finish up our show, we're going to discuss our favorite holiday traditions. Elena, why don't you go first?
I honestly don't have a ton of Christmas traditions with my family, but I do just love spending time with my family. I mean, we always do the regular old thing of we open presents and then we have a big family lunch together, and it's just always so fun. Ben, what about you?
You know, one of my favorite family traditions is we have a hot dog feast on Christmas Eve. One, my family celebrates on Christmas Eve, but we get hot dogs on Christmas Eve. We get the little baby Cokes in the glass bottles. Just a good time overall. But thank you guys for tuning in so much to Razorback Reels this Christmas. We really have a great time coming to you every semester with this show. And we've got some of our reporters, our festive reporters here at the BAM, kind of just showing off their festive attire. You know, happy holidays to everyone back home. So thank you guys so much for tuning in. I've been Ben Sawyers.
All right. And again, thank you so much for watching. I'm Elena Thompson.
Have a great night.